Hello guys and welcome to Being Dev. In this video we'll look into how parameter handling has changed in AS6. We will go through all of these topics. Let's start with the first one, that is default parameters. So in this side, on the left hand side, is how we used to set default values to the parameters before AS6. So you can see we are passing just the first argument while calling the function, and inside the function we are checking if the second and third arguments are undefined, and then we are setting those arguments to a default value. So eventually this function call will return 20 to us because B and C will be set to default values 4 and 15 respectively. But in AS6 we have better way to do the same thing. So while defining the function itself, you can mention the default values for the parameters. This is actually lesser code to write and this is more self-explanatory code. By just looking at the function definition, you can tell that you are setting default values. So these default values will be set only if you are not passing a value for these parameters. If you are passing value for B and C, the default values will not be taken into consideration and this function call will return 3 to us. Let's move on to the next topic, that is rest parameters. So what this is, this takes the rest of the parameters inside an array. The name rest here can be changed to anything. Rest is just a convention that is being widely used. So in this case, first two arguments 1 and 2 will be set to x and y, and all the other arguments will be passed onto an array named rest. You can do the same thing with all the parameters as well. For example, I can just remove x and y and return rest itself. So in this case, rest will take all the function arguments as an element of the array. Let's move on to the next topic, that is spread parameters. So in this case, you can pass an array as individual arguments to a function. So in this case, parameters is the array that we are passing as individual arguments. So saying this is same thing as saying this, because this is spreading all the elements of the array as different arguments. So depending upon the context where you are using these triple dots, it changes the meaning of those triple dots. For example, in this case, it takes all the rest of the arguments into an array, and in this case, it spreads the array elements as different arguments to the function. So this is doing spreading. This is doing gathering of the rest of the parameters. Let's move on to the next topic, that is destructuring. So AS6 has introduced another feature called destructuring. So for example, we have an array called a, b, and then we are assigning the value to be, let's say 3, 4. So in this case, it will destructure that and assign 3 and 4 to a and b respectively. We can do the same thing in case of objects as well. But in case of object, you just need to provide the property name over here. Let's say s, y are the property names. And s has the value to be 3 and y has the value to be 4 in this case. So it will destructure that as well, and s will come out to be 3 and y will come out to be 4 in this case. So let me just refresh this. So same thing happens when you pass similar values to function arguments. So in this case, the parameter accept x, y array, and we are passing 1, 2 as the argument. So this will be destructured and x will be assigned 1 and y will be assigned 2, and we will get 6 as the output. And in the second case as well, the object destructuring will happen. So we will get 6 as the output as well. And we can pass variables that are assigned object and array as well. Just be careful, because this will fail if you are not passing the expected argument. For example, in the first case, we are expecting array to be the first argument. So you need to pass an array to be the first argument. Just be careful about that. Let's move on to the next topic, that is lazy functions. So similar to defining default values inside the function definition, we can define those default values by calling a function as well. So in this case, this function is returning 15 and we are calling that function to define the default values. So a simple use case can be, so if we are having some unique ID over here, So a function is generating unique ID, and in case the user is passing the unique ID, we will take that one. Otherwise, we will get a unique ID by calling a function over here. So in this case, firstly, calling this function with only one argument will return 20, because B and C will get the default values, and calling this will return 1 plus 2 plus 3, that is 6. But why are these called lazy functions? The reason for that is before ES6, whenever we used this parenthesis after a function, that function was called immediately. But in this case, this function is not called until or unless it is needed. So in the first case, this is needed, so this function will be called. And in the second case, we don't need the default value of C, so that function will not be called at all. So this is the reason these are called lazy functions. And then some noteworthy points. So we saw those rest parameters and all. Okay, you remember we have arguments array in the function as well that contains all the arguments. So that arguments is not actually an array, that is an array like object. We can't use the array functions on that arguments array. So we can't use for each, map and all on that arguments array. But in this case, this is an actual array, and we can use all the array functions like map, for each on this. And then I want you to go through this example and understand for yourself how the destructuring and rest parameters are taking into consideration in these both examples. Okay, so all the best with that. And guys, if you have learned something from this video, please give it a like. If you have any queries or something, mention those in the comment section.